you are zipping along on the highway in heavy traffic, and suddenly it slows down and perhaps even comes to a halt. What? What idiots have caused this? When the traffic eventually gets moving again, there is no visible reason for the holdup. What's going on? Welcome to what is called a phantom traffic jam. These phantom jams might start with just a bump in the road or a driver who is distracted. When one driver brakes, the flow of traffic is interrupted, others have to brake, and then even more. One thing leads to another. When traffic is heavy, a pulse of braking vehicles is formed. Each driver braking leads others to brake, causing reinforcing feedback that creates a wave of slowed or stopped vehicles, and this wave grows bigger the further back it is from the original event. Research shows these waves moving back through the flow of traffic at about 20 kilometers per hour. By the time you come to a halt, you might be many kilometers from where the first driver braked. This phantom traffic jam is an example of how patterns emerge from the interactions between the parts of the system. In this case, the interactions between individual cars and with the volume of traffic on the road leads to gridlock. In complex adaptive systems, the character of the system comes from the interaction of its parts. It is not so much the pieces that matter, but the relationships between them. This is a critical idea for leaders in complexity, and it often surprises us. The idea that interactions are more important than people goes against most of our common sense. Usually we see the effect and go looking for the cause, and the cause is usually a person or a group of people. It's that unknown moron further up the traffic jam who has caused this. The human habit is to look for someone or some particular thing to blame or to praise, rather than looking for the ways that many things or people interacting have caused something to occur. This is despite the fact that whenever people gather together, we have a system, and systems have lives of their own. Organisational culture is an example of this. Leaders often talk about culture like it is a thing. We're going to change the culture. Sounds like having an oil change. But culture is not a thing. It's what happens between people, and it emerges from those interactions right across the team or the organisation, and from the responses to the rules, incentives, and expectations of the organisation. Another example is the use of targets within organisations. Let's offer to pay hospitals more if they do more operations per day. Then pay them a bonus if they reduce the number of patients who have to be readmitted. In some cases, this approach has worked well. More operations, improved care, and better results if the whole system is taken into account. But in other cases, these targets led to perverse outcomes, with hospitals moving patients around and reducing care to make sure they met their numbers. The rules of the system drive its behaviour. Unless we look at the whole system, its relationships, and the feedback in those relationships, we may not see the real nature of the problem. We are surprised when we discover it's not a thing or a person that's causing the problem, but instead comes from the interactions between people and other parts of the system. We are also surprised by the ways these interactions play out. They expand and contract in unpredictable ways. How stories flow through groups is a good example of this. If it's a juicy piece of gossip, it may take off, go viral, spread like wildfire. The story can grow much bigger in the telling. The interactions can reinforce and amplify. But if it's news that people do not want to hear, then the feedback process can dampen things down. People pour cold water on others' ideas, or it's like driving a bus into the sand. As leaders, what can you look out for here? First, watch for whether you tend to be telling stories where people are to blame or are heroes, including you, when it's the interplay of elements of the system that's giving you what you are getting. Ask yourself, which interactions seem to be shaping the system? Are these exploding like a virus, or do they dampen things down? What elements of the system might I experiment with? And sometimes you just find yourself stuck in a system you cannot change. When traffic is crawling and you are already late, all you might be able to do is breathe, meditate, listen to your favorite tracks, and feel compassion for yourself and all the frustration around you. The only part of a system you might be able to change in the moment is you.